Hi everyone, and welcome back to our Let's Play video blogcast thing. I'm ewhac.
I'm Gammadev.
And we're trying out Need for Speed from Electronic Arts, or Rodent Track, or one of the two. It's called Rodent Track's The Need for Speed.
Rodent Track presents The Need
for Speed. The Need for Speed, yes. The Need for Speed.
Yes, this was...
Which was recently released as a major motion picture.
Yes, starring not Paul Walker. Starring Jesse from Breaking Bad, if those of you who watch Breaking Bad. I saw some reviews, Savage Likes, like, how'd they find all those co-stars who are shorter than he is? Like, he was not the most intimidating character on Breaking Bad. But, yeah. Pioneer Productions, this is was a small office, I believe, associated with EA Canada. I think might have been EA Burnaby.
Ah, okay.
Which they no longer had. They basically gave the Need for Speed license over recently to Criterion.
Ah.
And then I understand they then turned another studio off of Criterion to make just Need for Speed.
Oh, okay.
So, because the Criterion guys had Burnout for the longest time.
Yeah, and, right.
And people were kind of like...
I should enjoy Burnout. I haven't played it for a while, but I still enjoy it.
I mean, the latest Need for Speed... The last two are basically Burnout.
Okay.
I mean, so, because basically people love the gameplay of Burnout, but the name Need for Speed is considered more prestige. Mm. So it was like...
Well, it's been around longer, certainly.
Yeah. Yeah. But yeah, this one was very much a simulation.
Oh, so they're trying to do accurate vehicle...
This first one, yes. And then when it got ported, it got dumbed down because... Mm. Okay, I remember this. This came out December 94, I believe.
Sounds about right.
And we had this at the office.
Tired of warming the bench.
One of the office meetings, Friday meetings.
Yeah.
And they had side-by-side with the newly released PlayStation.
With Ridge Racer.
Ridge Racer in it. Yeah. And I remember Martin.
Martin Tyler?
Hunt.
Martin Hunt, okay.
We were looking at them, and he thought this one was the PlayStation one. And I said, no, that's the 3DO. And he looked over at Ridge Racer, and they looked at this one, and he goes, oh, we got nothing to worry about. Because, put them side by side, this looks better.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, it's not... We know how that went. People liked, I guess, the arcade-y style a little better, and mm-hmm. so that's why when this game on the PlayStation, they massively upped the cartoony physics and, you know, toned down the simulation, and it became very much like Ridge Racer. And it's kind of funny, because Sony... I think looked at Need for Speed, this one, and then said, oh, we need something like that, and they developed like Gran Turismo, which is like a Puritan that which now lives today as a fetishist, car fetishist thing. Oh yeah, I remember this.
Oh great,
now
figure out how this UI works.
This guy. Sadly, passed away very recently. Brenan Baird, I'm going to say his name is.
He's just the...
He plays X-Man.
Just X-Man is the
his
name.
Yeah, I don't know how...
Is the name of the character.
Past Marvel.
You got two options. You can take this baby out and run her up against the clock. Or for the initiated, I suggest a little challenge. A little one-on-one, a little mano-a-mano.
He's your adversary in the game. And he's basically the guy you're supposed to be racing against. He's the guy in the other car.
So this guy is like early 90s Tood.
Yeah.
Okay.
And they cut him from all the other versions, as far as I know, except maybe the PC had him in it, but because that was closer to the 3DO version than the other two, than the like you know the PlayStation. I think there was a Saturn version, but they cut him out.
There's a completely different character in every aspect, but I'm reminded of Lance Boyle from the Mega Race, but he wasn't a competitor. He was the
announcer.
He was the announcer. Yeah.
Yeah, announcers. Don't be surround.
Thanks for the courier font, guys. That works really good at 320 by 240.
Whatever.
Yes, Dolby. Dolby Surround had just come out.
Are they going to show you what the control panel is?
Oh, good.
Downshift, upshift.
Yes, everyone was buying new television sets so that you could listen to Star Trek The Next Generation in surround sound.
I like, let's see, accelerator. I'm really torn here as to what to do here.
Okay, somebody had way too much free time to animate this.
No, that's an easy thing to do. That's an easy thing to program to do this. Okay. So it's like, do I want to use the shift buttons for turning, or do I want to use...
The joypad for turning.
I'm guessing that probably...
Jeez, you can't have... Well, interesting, you can't have the...
I want the accelerator on the A button internally. Okay, that's probably more like it. That makes more sense to me.
All right. Turning on the shoulders. A, B, yeah, okay. Control. Four. Config okay. Four.
Yeah, well, yeah. Novice auto shift. Yeah, let's go for that. Yeah, okay. Oh, wait. Is that... Do I hit... You think they've almost gotten this down. Okay. So that's obviously start the race. Mm-hmm. This is...
Select your car, I guess.
Maybe. Oh, that's right. You have to, like all the good games, I think that's...
You have to fight your way to new cars?
That helps put the VT's 492 brake horsepower to the ground. Up to 15% of the power is put through to the front wheels when the rear's brake track.
Now, the modern games, price $250,000. Modern games, you start off with like a Honda, and you'd have to unlock. Then you unlock. You spend like 20 hours unlocking these things.
The two-stroke
nowadays,
leaf blower and work your way up.
Thanks to the ability of, you know, of DLC and consumables, you could just buy the car.
Yeah.
There's been some major backlash about that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But,
there's just so much backlash that apparently there was a session at GDC called Managing Backlash.
Get to see some videos. This was where they spent their money on the Road and Track. I don't know if the other ones were called Road and Track Presents.
This is pre-Top Gear, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. I don't know.
Clarkson farting around in this somewhere.
I don't know. When did that start in the UK?
I don't recall.
But yeah, look at these lovely videos.
Less than 20 years ago.
Yeah. Whereas, meanwhile, Ridge Racer, the entire game fit in memory. Remember, they thought that was a feature, that you could pop the disc out and then pop a CD in while you're playing Ridge Racer, because everything, there was no streaming, because they didn't know how to on the PlayStation at that point in time when they launched it. So, and I remember they had that problem, too, with streaming on the... when they did the Need for Speed port, they actually broke up the tracks instead of one long track. They actually would break it up into load sections. You do a tiny little section, load.
Oh, you're going through a tunnel.
Yeah, it was not fun. And the other thing, maybe you should look this up. There is a in-game cheat code for this to disable the dashboard. So basically, you're driving.
Oh, just stuff.
It's
just
not. You could do it.
Stuff. I'm sorry. Just the rendered out the actual road.
So you're still playing from the car's point of view, but it gets rid of the dash. It greatly increases the sensation of speed.
Hmm.
And that it was added to the the other ports.
Okay.
Because there was at all, it's like the other ones are much faster. It's like, okay, yeah, they've artificially inflated the speed. Frame rate wise is not actually going that much faster. And just being able to see the road rushing past you without the dashboard there greatly increases the sensation of speed.
Okay. But... Oh, hello. I see what you're saying.
So it's like, oh.
Okay, have you started yet?
I'm going backwards. Now he's going to say something snarky.
nothing.
More than you bargained for? Too real for you?
If I were you, I'd keep this little episode quiet.
Okay, feather hair.
There's a lot of... Just look at a high score of that. Oh, yeah. I wonder how much that takes up in the old 2K of RAM.
Basically, well, you get 4,000 points for doing nothing.
It's the participation trophy that you get. Okay. I have not played this in a long time.
Okay. I haven't really played it at all.
No.
Which is why I handed the controls over to you.
Well... So, anyway.
All right.
This was one of the games I bought for my parents when I got them a 3DO on Christmas.
Oh, okay.
My mom does not drive in real life. She never has. She never learned to drive for whatever reason.
All right.
I guess she's just at that perfect point in time. And also because, you know. Oh, that's right. I set the...
the shoulder buttons are steering for you, yes.
Ooh.
Oh, okay. All right. So this frame rate is much better than I remember.
Now, my mom, she used to love...
I think you have to throw it into reverse gear.
Oh, I keep forgetting that I set steer to... My mom, on the other hand, she actually made a game of her own, which was, see if you can knock over all the lampposts really? And street signs. And she just literally go up to it, and she would do this. She'd go, ha ha, smash. So basically, she just made her own game out of it. Because, you know, she doesn't drive in real life, right? Uh-huh. And after seeing that, I was like, I was not encouraged to say, okay, maybe there's a reason why you shouldn't be able to drive in real life. Now, has your mom ever played video games?
No.
No?
No. In fact, she just got her first... I gave it to her. She just got her first computer for Christmas last year.
Computer?
In 2013. Well, a tablet. Her first computing device.
Let's be real now.
Yeah. I mean...
tablet is not a real computer.
All right. But still...
I'm purposely driving on the shoulder.
First exposure to any kind of modern computing at all. And it is fascinating to look at how someone who has never really used a computer before... is confronted by this. Because, I mean, it occurred to me, like, you know, after I first gave it to her. So there's the wallpaper for the tablet, and then there's all the icons that do things. And she doesn't know how to differentiate for them. She thinks it's all just a picture. It's just a featureless picture. And I realized...
So remove the wallpaper.
Right, that's what I did. I changed the wallpaper to something really, really simple so that it wouldn't... confuse.
Right, didn't want to get one of those animated like ripples on the pond.
I didn't want to do that because it was going to kill the battery. But so I've been helping her out with that. You know, crash damage. Yep. So I've been helping her out a little bit with
my fuzzbusters going off there.
And the reason that she was interested in this at all is because all her friends have gone to email. So, you know, we've got to get her on. On the Matrix. So I got her an Android tablet for Christmas.
Yay.
The only prior exposure my parents ever had to computers was whatever I was messing around with in my bedroom.
Hello. Oh no, it is the man.
I hope we don't get carted to the big house.
And one of these other views, I can turn on the rear view mirror and it will show him coming up in my... Not that one. No.
Oh. Yeah. Oh, jeez.
See, this is the one where it's like I said, there is a cheat code.
Uh-huh.
There's a button combo to press that will get rid of the dashboard, but you play from this view.
Uh-huh.
And then the sensation of speed is really, really good.
Uh-huh.
Hey, I recognize these tunnels from Road Rash. No. I love the fact that when you spin out, you automatically jump out of the view. Some people might find that annoying, but it's like to give you some sense of, you know, orientation, mm-hmm. like, right. Oh, what happened? Because otherwise it might be a little confusing.
Express lane closed.
I'm driving on the shoulder because there's a funny video, which my mom found.
Uh-huh.
When she...
okay.
Which, if you spend a lot of time, like, over here...
Yeah.
He will make a little snarky remark about it.
Oh. Hey, yeah, another one. Too bad that doesn't keep score on that. Or does it? Damage, you know, environmental damage? Or?
Well, they just literally just lay the sprite down when they don't...
Yeah, I saw that.
There's no physics that goes flying or anything. We're going to save that for the sequel, which we never got.
No. Oh!
Nope, going the wrong way. Eventually we'll get there. It's a leisurely drive.
So they're trying to simulate an actual Lamborghini.
This is more, it's definitely physics. You can get some major error in these things too, which is kind of fun. You're not playing like slot cars like you are in Ridge Racer or something.
Now when M2 was being worked on, the studio guys were trying to work on an accurate racing simulator.
Yes, IMSA Racing.
IMSA Racing, that's right.
Which I have a copy of.
Oh.
We'll have to play that at some point.
Will. We will. We'll have to dig that up.
Which, yes, they licensed the physics, the car physics engine from that was used in this as well. I guess I don't know if they licensed it from EA or they licensed from the people who licensed the EA license from.
Nice.
Which I actually think goes all the way back to hard driving. I think they actually.
Oh. Wait, Hard Drivin', that was...
Oh, Atari.
It was Morrison worked on that, didn't he?
Yeah, but I think they had a... Yes, I think they had an external physics guy.
I see. Okay.
Shoulder.
Yep.
Does the word shoulder mean anything to you? Well, I guess we can throw out the old driver's ed manual. If it's flat, you're going to drive on it.
I don't understand why they took this out of the final. Highlight reel. Oh, please. Let's see,
let's see what that is.
Which is kind of cool. I mean, does that mean they actually recorded all your game data and then so they could play it back? Got to eat up a
tail cam.
I guess you can replay the entire race, which means they're devoting a good chunk of RAM to recording all the.
Oh, wait.
Oh, you mean this lovely three-point turn? Anytime I probably make contact with another car, they probably say that's an event you got to record. That. Yep. As I sneak by the officer and evening officer, nothing going on here.
Ah. You almost recovered that perfectly.
Almost. One of these I did recover.
Yeah. Squish.
So has your mom been introduced to Angry Birds yet?
No.
Do you want to introduce her to Angry Birds?
Not really.
Or how about threes?
I suppose. I don't know what that is.
Basically, it's a game you spend a dollar for where basically you're a human spreadsheet. if I want to do math, I'm not going to pay you money to do it. I'm going to pay you money. You're going to do it. It's like really dumbed down Sudoku as far as I'm concerned.
Well, she really likes Sudoku, so I did install a Sudoku app for her. Uh-oh. But
really?
Again, it's just
she's like my dad. She probably likes Mahjong, or not Mahjong, but I guess Shanghai, you know, the one where you're actually, you know, not real Mahjong, but the start of it counts as, or is he just redoing it? Through traffic. Okay. Oh, wait, where's the...
But again, it's just she's got to get used to the user interface concepts.
Oh, wait. Do I want to continue? I want to select the track, because there's like the extended... there's some really lovely tracks here, I guess.
I get it. Yeah, that looks like...
The city.
From the tranquility of suburbia to the pandemonium of...
Alpine, coastal... Coastal, is that the one? That's the one that ends with, well, here, we'll go Alpine.
I'm trying to find the, here it is.
What?
Okay, during the game, switch to first-person view and press the following on controller 2.
Ah.
Up plus L plus A. And that makes the dashboard turn off.
Oh. It's kind of like the old Control-Alt-Delete, up L A. Which still works as like right, both triggers and the black button is like on the Xbox controller was sort of like Control-Alt-Delete and sort of So we're gonna do the Alpine track.
This is weird.
Somebody would have to
amazing get... accidents that don't occur cheat. When loading a race versus the computer, press and hold LR and left. When you get to the starting line, quit the game. Restart the game again. At the loading screen, press and hold LR and up. You'll get to the starting line, quit again, restart the game at the loading screen, plus and hold LR and right, get to the starting line and quit, start the game again for the fourth and final time, at the loading screen, press, hold LR and down. This time, race. Whenever you race, press X to make amazing accidents happen to cars near you.
Hey, the cows are back from road rash.
Moo. Moo.
So notice the cops never go after X.
Nah, yeah. Hi there. Excuse me, pardon me, pardon me, excuse me. Oh no, uphill.
See if I can get some air.
108. Haha. I think the hills are a little too gentle for that.
Oh, for a baton. Now, see, why wasn't that a cheat? I guess the spectacular crash thing. I imagine it's basically the cars probably just catapult straight up in the air as you go by.
Ah, yes. It's highway 85 to Half Moon Bay, I think.
Really? You think?
Well, it's, yeah, well, it's got that nice steep and twisty whatever.
See, nowadays, they would just make a... they just use Google Maps data and just
Yeah. Rather than drawing it themselves.
One of these buttons, I think, turns on the at the rear view mirror. Oh, wait, no. I can't remember if... I think I did accidentally click the handbrake there. Hi, officer. You gonna come after me? Throw out the spike strip?
I don't understand. There's no stars.
You mean GTA stars? Or yeah, you mean GTA Mario stars. Kart stars?
It is always stars.
Blue shell, no! Ah, yes.
Geez, the law enforcement presence in this universe is pretty high.
Whoa, was that a moose? Now, in real life, they'd be bounding across the road, aiming straight for your car.
Yeah.
I don't know, is that a problem around here? Like it is in the Midwest?
No.
Do you see like the they don't have, you ever see like deer crossing signs or whatever kind of warning you? It's like you
know. Occasionally, but I mean, it doesn't. So I'm not driving the hills very much, but it doesn't happen. It's never happened to me terribly.
Oh, if he gets in front of you, basically.
Oh.
So. Yeah, go after X-Man, would you please? Thank you very much.
He was behind you. He goes. Spinning out on gravel.
You mean on foliage or green gravel?
Yeah, could have been painted.
See, as we're winding our way up, and it's, yeah, I guess this is basically it's probably California, since you know, which is odd because this is made in Canada. you start up here, soon you'll get into like the snowy areas, like apparently there was some snowfall around here recently.
Oh, there you go.
Around here recently. I want to say like Thursday or Friday, the rain in up in the mountain areas was actual snow.
Huh.
Yeah. They had a thing about you had to have chains on your car and stuff. Mm-hmm. You know.
We had a little rain here a couple days ago.
Yeah, in the Midwest around here, you'd see deer crossing signs, and they actually have a campaign which is like don't veer for deer.
Really?
Basically, it's like you don't try to avoid deer. You're more likely to be damaged than if you just hit them because. You would likely, just go off the road.
Uh-huh.
Hi, officer. Oh, you're probably going to come after me, aren't you? The cops out here must have really good budget, have a great budget to afford a car than keep up with a freaking Lamborghini. Okay. Hey, there's X. Oh, no. Is he catching up?
Nope.
I'm not hearing the little blip anymore.
Yeah, does that indicate someone law enforcement in front of you, law enforcement behind you?
Of course, they never go after X.
No, they don't.
I guess he paid off
just
the cops.
Just a bridge, or is that?
Bridge racer. No. Yes.
Yeah.
Oh my God! Oh no! He was at the end. And down there. His James Dean's car down there.
Oh,
what? Too soon?
Fancy driving. Unfortunately, every cop west of the Mississippi is looking for you, but hey, fancy driving.
Couldn't he ended the take before he closed his eyes?
Was he a radio personality or?
No, he's an actor.
Okay.
Was an actor. Mm-hmm. I looked up his IMDb. He was in stuff.
Oh, okay.
Nothing. nothing major. Not to diminish his career or anything, but wasn't like, hey, he later went on to be, you know, I mean, nothing dishonorable or anything. But yes, it's sad. He was only like 50 or so.
Yeah, don't remind me. Oh, reverse. It, or something.
It's like, ooh, climbing up into the mountains here.
Oh, is this stage two the same? Or is this the same track?
Yes, this is stage two.
Okay.
Leg two of the...
Oh, I see.
Yeah, the coast one is pretty cool, too. Yeah, bite me. I think if you get like three tickets, the game's over.
That sounds about right.
Three lives, why not?
Yeah. Sure.
But it's clever, because it's tickets, man. It's... I think you can also damage your car.
I think in real life, if they catch you doing over 100, that's it. You know,
this is California. Okay, yeah. All right, we'll let you go with the warning since you're making a video game and all.
Yeah.
Or a crappy movie starring Aaron Paul.
Yeah.
Oh, speaking.
The movie Bob, like, gave that movie a serious drubbing.
Yeah. I watch those Cinema Snob guys who like just do their review in the car after coming out of the movie.
Oh, yeah.
And they did actually, relatively speaking, it wasn't a total train wreck, is what they're saying. It's just that come on, lady. I'm just, well, or, well, could be a gentleman, I guess. I just can't think of any self-respecting man who would drive a car that color. Uh-oh. He's gonna catch up. Sometimes you can force the cops off the road, but it's much harder than, say, a road rash.
Yeah. Or force them into a collision of some sort.
Hey, look at that red guy in front of me. He's red. Come on, you gotta go after him. He's red.
Look out for the lake.
Ah! Look out for the Golden Gate Bridge, or not. I don't know what bridge that's supposed to be. It's like, we didn't want to do the Golden Gate Bridge, so we'll do something kind of like
some, the some programmers bridge. Showing off somewhere. Some, it's like, look, we can do a bridge. Look, we're fading in more landscape. No, he's getting further away.
Isn't he eventually out of his jurisdiction? Oh, sorry. Next county over. Somebody else's problem. Not mine. Like the cop in Giant Gila Monster. Oh, I'm sorry, that's out of my jurisdiction. Uh-oh. Think he's just going to give up? Your car just magically slows down. We'll assume he's got some EM pulse thingy. Oh, hey!
Uh-huh. All right.
I crashed the cop. Yeah, that won't cause any repercussions whatsoever in this universe.
Nope, nope. You're fine.
Where's the helicopter?
Oh. Straight out of Spy Hunter.
Ah, see, that would have been a great early 32-bit. I mean, they later turned into like a PS2 game. Spy Hunter was kind of like this, but and it was okay. But it would have been a great kickoff to the. Oh, jeez.
We just got rid of
and
your
this
colleague.
Guy too. It's the same freaking yellow car. I blame him. How did he get ahead of me? Oh, okay. It's like there's only a few car models or something. It's sort of a taxi cab, but not. Yes. So should we mention the previous podcast?
Oh, you mean concerning...
Oh, no!
Concerning JPI?
Yeah.
I was actually going to mention...
Oh, he's got me magically slowed down. Wait, what?
What?
What is that?
I don't know.
I was going to T-bone him, man.
Oh. I actually was going to mention, last week, as of this recording, the great Yahtzee Croshaw and his compatriot Gabriel recorded a Let's Drown Out of Jurassic Park for the NES. Which I haven't listened to yet. I'm actually way behind on Yahtzee's Let's Drown Outs. Was there something you wanted to bring up? Or?
Well, yeah, we sort of implied there was a contest.
Oh. Yeah, we sort of implied that. You sort of implied that.
Okay. Hey, I keep my word.
Sure.
And I was, and somebody did actually, well, multiple people did, but one person figured out your secret identity. Although I guess it's not that hard.
No, it's not.
Between Moby games, you can probably figure this out really easy.
Mm-hmm.
So and located you, and then they made it really easy on the Starcade website, because they could actually search people by name. I didn't realize that. I thought they were gonna have to go to archive.org. You'd have to actually just they'd have to go through every video, since there's no metadata. But no, the guys at JM Productions apparently decided to make it easy, and so very quickly somebody found your earlier claim to fame.
Man,
that's actually why I asked if your mom played video games, because they on Starcade they had the parents.
Parent-child, yeah.
Oh. Which was always a big sham. That guy was already in motion, and X-Men clipped him. He didn't go after him, but yeah. And I thought, yeah. Which was, those were always funny episodes, because most of the time the parents couldn't play at all.
Right.
And so, like, they made the parents, they had to play a certain round, right? And so you're just like, okay, what's the lowest scoring game possible that we can give to the parents that we can, you know, make up for with, like, Star Wars or something like that that's really high scoring? Hey, look at this guy. He's passing me. So obviously, officer, you want to go after him.
I didn't say this
game
was
fair. Keep expecting to see Devil's Tower in the background here.
Shoot.
I think if he gets you over to the shoulder, that's what it is. It's like he has to get you onto the shoulder and ahead of you.
Okay.
So if you can get me, if you can like push me off the road, if I can just get to the finish line, which I think is shortly.
Yeah, I'm still a little puzzled as how he's able to pass you.
It's right there.
Yikes.
Oh, shit.
It's this jerk again!
It's Yellow Man! Is he going to show up? I guess if across the finish line, it doesn't count. That must be the county line. And, okay, X, what do you say?
Now that's what I like to see, a healthy disrespect for the law.
Okay.
Alrighty. They found...
dog, man. Oh, well, you have me breaking a sweat there, bud. But close only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades, my friend. I win, you lose. Oh, ain't it sweet?
Dude, yeah,
close only counts in horseshoes, hand grenades, and thermonuclear war.
What's the continue, then?
I don't know.
Diablo.
Yep.
El Diablo. But yes, we have a prize ready for the person who you are going to contact, because it's your YouTube account.
Okay.
get a shipping address for, and
do you recall the ID of the winner?
I would have to look at it, because it's not a real name, it's a YouTube name, so it's like
it's all Google, so they can all talk to each other.
You have a phone, you can look it up, you know.
Yeah, but I mean,
he listed the two episodes, and it was also and lovely. YouTube does a timestamp on it, so. And if I vaguely remember the name, but I'm sure if I say it, I'll probably mess it up.
Mm-hmm.
So,
jeez, where do we even start?
Right, actually, I should look at these if I recognize any of these people.
they are from EA Canada.
Oh, Frank, recognize Frank?
Frank Chabot.
Yeah. Because he was Don Matrick, now at Microsoft. Is he still at Microsoft? There's all this corporate head bingo that goes on there. Because I think Don Matrick used to be at EA, then he traded places with the ex-Sega guy who was at Microsoft. So Don Matrick went to Microsoft the same time that he's head of EA Sports now. He was Sega's most notorious guy in terms of.
He wasn't the Sega guy that we poached.
No.
Okay.
No. And he's famous for getting the tattoo for the release date of Halo on his arm or something which went over to Microsoft or whatever.
I see.
He's British, but he in Sega he moved over to live in San Francisco, and then that's why he wanted to come back to San Francisco. I think was because that's what I heard. But anyway. He's now head of EA Sports. Why is that name slipping my mind? But yeah, Don Matrick, I think recently, I thought he went to Microsoft, and I'm not sure if he then left shortly after the Xbox One launch or what the deal is, and then went to, I want to say, I'm probably totally messing this up. I want to say someplace like Zynga, but maybe not Zynga. Or maybe it was, I don't know. If I had my tablet, I would tell you in a second. it's much easier on my tablet to do this.
Here I am trying to get the... Shut up. I'm just trying to get the... jeez. Trying to get to the comment section on my phone.
The Android version of the thing?
The Android version of YouTube. Which apparently... Did I look at the comments?
If I remember correctly, if anybody's seen the end of the... The coastal track is kind of cool.
Okay.
Because do you remember the ending of the coastal track?
No, I don't.
you'll get a chuckle. And if you can guess what it is, I'll give you. No. What the heck?
Well, apparently.
Am I going to find it before you will?
Probably. I'm using the Android YouTube.
It's the last video you posted, so it's not like
no. It's all, I found the video. What I can't seem to figure out is how to get the comments to come up.
Oh, I believe it's you had to.
There you go. He's got it too.
Yeah, I know. But if I remember correctly. Yeah, it's not. I think you have to expand it.
Oh, there it is. It's way on the bottom.
Yeah, it's they've recently.
Let's see. So,
they keep messing with the. Now, do you have a Chromecast?
No, I don't have a Chromecast yet.
Oh wait, does your TV even have HDMI?
Yes, it does.
Okay.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, three of them.
Really? Yeah. Sure, they're not DVI ports. Masquerading as HDMI.
I know they're HDMI ports because the cables keep falling out of them.
Ah, aren't we bitter? No, I agree. It's HDMI is really the worst cabling standard ever created. I mean, it's just the fact is there's the 1.4 was really a joke. There's no reason for 1.4 to exist if they actually did their standard correct, because it doesn't actually do anything. Can I pause? Oh, look, you can pause. Awesome.
Oh, okay. All right. this is looking like Outrun here.
Except you don't have a...
Oh, here we...
That sounds about right.
Does that sound right?
Well, hold on. We might have to edit that, because there's multiple people guessed, but one came in definitely first.
Right.
Dun, dun, dun. And there's a timestamp on. Unfortunately, there at the time I watched it, there was a decent timestamp on it because. No, but now it's
one month ago.
Yeah, it's Wait, isn't it? I think it's actually wasn't it Death Lord X? I found you.
Ah, okay. We're gonna have to go through. I'm.
By the way, I like your hair.
Yeah. Then or now? Yes.
So bleep out the other name just so that we don't get a false positive in some way, because as we learned from. That one place where we worked before, after 3DO.
Yeah.
Just because somebody thinks they won, they can actually bring a lawsuit against you. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Remember, that's the light on the machine went off. Oh. Somebody told me that means I won, so therefore I'm going to sue. It's that's not what the light on top of the machine means. Yeah, but somebody told me that, therefore I believe that, therefore I'm entitled to the prize. It's no. Where does that come from? Yes. In what universe does that live? Well, apparently the United States is the universe, especially where you can get a judge to agree with you.
Yeah, the universe of casino gaming.
Yes.
Anyway, so we're officially saying the Death Lord X.
Yes.
Okay.
He's first on the list.
He appears to be first on the list.
Didn't he also list both episodes?
No, he did not. He listed episode 62. There was another one who apparently listed both episodes, but Death Lord X had the first one. Apparently, if we go by the sequence they appear.
What was the other one? But obviously.
So we have Death Lord X who identified one episode, and we have. Who identified both episodes.
So my memory was when we looked at this, and I looked at the timestamps when timestamps were meaningful.
Yes.
Like,
helpful.
Within an hour after it was posted or so, it was Death Lord X because that type of name sticks in my mind. Instead of like thinking, I'm not dissing your name, dude. I'm just saying, my handle sucks too on YouTube. So I have several, but. And none of them are good. It's like, and Google keeps offering to like change them for me and stuff like that. I'm just like, yeah, no. None of the alternative, because all the good ones are now taken.
Yeah.
It would just be my name. And it's like, well, screw that. I don't want just my name.
So.
Oh, actually, I shouldn't say that because. Well, I'll get home before you do this. Because yes, there is one that they keep offering to me that I haven't taken. I probably should take.
So anyway, yes, Death Lord X, get in touch with me, ewhac, and
You could message him, you know.
Yeah, I can message you or something, and.
Or is that going to be part of the contest? You have to like listen 2 weeks in a row.
Oh, nice! Oh, did it break? Did it break?
Oh, if you roll it, I think yeah.
Oh my gosh.
At least I got the cop off me.
Oh, sympathy. You roll.
Well, no, because I think I get a max of 3 tickets and also 3 cars. So mm-hmm. Seems somewhat asymmetrical in that regard. But
So Death Lord X, I'll send you a message. And what's he going to receive?
Well, from me.
Yes.
I'm contributing a piece of my 3DO collection.
Uh-huh.
It's a Japanese copy of Jurassic Park Interactive. Or maybe we should bleep that out, and then we'll let him, he's got to, like, he has to post saying what it was. And let us know if he finds it appropriate, or, if, you know, who knows, maybe the Japanese makes it better. I don't know. You know, something that people, like, I always wonder when I see, like, animes in their, like, original language.
Yeah.
And I've seen this in games, too, where it's like, oh, this is so wonderful and so deep and meaningful. But if you actually maybe understood the actual language, you're like, God, this is cheesy. Because you say, well, the dubbing is terrible. It's like, yeah, but maybe it's literally just the lines. Like, you see, like, you know, these fighting games. Because actually, somebody was saying they'd watched a dub version or a semi-dub version of The Phantom Menace.
Oh.
And that Jar Jar is not nearly as annoying when he's dubbed. And somebody did that where they, like, basically left him, like,
Could dub Christopher Walken over Jar Jar, and he wouldn't be annoying.
I think they might have done this in the Phantom Edit too, which is fans like recut of it.
Yes,
if you actually look at it, I haven't looked at the whole thing, but parts of it was like there's not that many significant changes. But apparently, one of the big things they did was they gave Jar Jar his own language, so he's like Chewbacca essentially. He's just like doing that.
All right.
What they dub in is not what he's actually saying, but like. Kind of these zen kind of like almost haiku like things. So that, you know, I assume that also means they had to cut out him like stepping in poo or whatever that was and stuff like that happened in the actual movie. But
all right,
but they said it's like, oh, it proves the thing much better. And it's like, yeah, so maybe if, you know, like, you know, there's certain actors that I find annoying. I bet it's like, I wonder if, like, if you see a dub version, if it like plays totally differently. Like, this person's not nearly as annoying.
I wonder if you can go sailing over the cliff.
No.
No? Oh, damn.
There's invisible walls.
Nice drive. Couple nice moves. But most of it in the oncoming lane. Aish!
Yeah, whatever. Aish, what was that? So I mentioned...
Just improv something, dude.
I just mentioned... Yeah.
We're rolling. Come on.
Clock's I mentioned front. Your mom.
Yeah.
Like, games, because, you know, Mother's Day is coming up.
It's like, oh, Lord. Yeah.
You ever get some snazzy accessories for her Android tablet?
Actually, what she could really do with is a proper keyboard. That was another thing I learned, is that she is old enough that she used real typewriters back in the day. And so her fingers are still moving for those positions. But on at least the Samsung tablet, the keyboard is squinched vertically. And so I was watching her thumb and she would go for the space bar, and she was like way below it and hitting like the edge of the tablet itself, like well beyond the edge of the display.
Interesting.
And so I said, okay, she's going to need a proper keyboard. Also,
maybe she got a Surface.
Yeah.
That user interface for Windows 8, say what you will about it, but the touch interface on that is actually probably the simplest of all the tablets. There you go. It's very intuitive in terms of, like, you know, swipe, touch, little tiles, very simple. There's no confusing it with the background. The live tile thing makes sense. Well, no, you can have a background on that thing. But yeah, I mean, have you tried 8 or 8.1 more specifically?
Basically I walk up to it in a store and immediately I'm completely unable to use it because they went and changed everything. It's like one of the first things I want to do when I'm looking at a machine is say, okay, what's the resolution of this screen? You know, so that if it turns out it's 1366 by 768, I can be pissed off.
What are you talking about?
So I have a laptop. It's like 6 years old, and the resolution of this screen, it's a 14-inch laptop. Resolution of the display is 1440 by 900. This is 7 years ago, or 7 years ago. And I figured, okay, display resolution is just going to keep getting better. Whoa, impressive.
Oh, I rolled it. Normally I can survive that.
And you're on your back, waving your legs. Interesting with the balloons there.
Yes.
So I figured, it's like, okay, display resolution is just getting better and better. No. There's some conspiracy somewhere that basically has stuck laptops with 1366 by 768.
Well, cheap
laptops.
I want
to find this man and punch him.
Cheap laptops. Everything else is HD or better now. Well, that if you're at 14 inches and you're not HD, you're like, oh, how ghetto. You know?
Well, actually, you go on Lenovo's website, and their little machines, you know, they're like their 11-inch machines, 1366 by 768, that's all it is.
They're cheap ones. That's all
you
get.
No, these are not. These are like, i5s.
No, first of all, i5 is not an expensive processor. Second of all,
there's
an HD option, or there's a model that's HD. Trust me on this.
Uh-huh.
You're looking at the cheap ones. Because, yes, that is the absolute bargain basement for resolutions right now. So, but amazingly, Windows 8 actually looks good at that resolution, shockingly. That's one of the things they work a lot on, that interface. Surprised when you don't have all this, you know, bevely glass kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And it's funny that that both Android and the iPhone are starting to adopt that style, that flattened style. Because it's like, yes, it's clearer, it's sharper. You shouldn't waste pixels on bezels. And drawing little, you know...
Skeuomorphism.
Or whatever. Or making your thing look like, you know, NyQuil liquid caps and all that stuff.
Yes.
But
the lickable user interface.
But you know, I have both an Android tablet and I got a Surface real cheap, a first gen Surface.
Okay.
And I use it as my bedside kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And shockingly, I even got one of those cheap touch covers that they have, and it's actually fairly typable. They have both the touch and then the type cover, which actually has, you know, keys that actually move.
Ah,
you know?
Yeah.
But still ridiculously thin.
Mm-hmm.
But even the touch one, I was like, oh, this is in a pinch, this works, you know.
Mm-hmm.
If I really wanted to do some extensive typing, I'd be, ooh, pretty.
Yes. Oh, and they even changed the sound effects. Actually, it sounds like you're going through a tunnel.
Yeah, this was so much better than Ridge Racer. Ridge Racer! But, you know, I don't know why they... Well, okay, yeah, Ridge Racer is why they dumbed this down when they ported this. And then the second version was, you know, pure arcade action, you know.
Mm-hmm.
This was so lovely. It's so beautiful. I can't help it. So I'll drive right off the edge there. Let's reenact that scene from Brainstorm. Where's my semi-truck? There's an obscure...
What? Oh, come...
You this guy, him. It's like, pass him, come on. All right, now let's reenact the last scene from Duel. Okay. That's going back to the 70s.
Yep.
Oh, really? This guy? Wow, get this guy for tailgating, for Christ's sake.
Whoa, hey, he went right through him.
Well, you know.
He clipped right through him.
You call that stunt action physics. Which means no physics at all whatsoever. How does he suddenly...
Yeah, well, I mean...
Was he drafting before? Was that what that was?
I'm super...
Now drafting. On Mythbusters.
Hypermiling. Ah.
Yeah, he's driving a hybrid. Lamborghini or whatever.
Yeah.
Oh, he basically saves it the last minute to beat me.
Clunk.
See, that part would delight my mom. Taking out the sign. Yeah, who is that? Somebody I
nice
really...
drive.
Yeah, we saw him. We saw nice this already.
But somebody was talking about, like, they're trying to introduce their mom to, like, video games, and he was doing it around the launch of the 360.
He's trying to introduce with what?
Wait, what? That's not the end of it? Did I miss it?
No, that was it. That was the finish.
Wait a minute. No.
What?
The end of the coast. Was I just not paying attention?
That was the second segment. Was there more to it? Do you remember?
There's three segments.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Do you have to do like a...
Do you have to like win first or pick a different car?
Because the end of it... I guess maybe I have to do like a full race with him where I do like all three. Because at the end of this... Okay, spoiler. It's the end of the Planet of the Apes where there's the Statue of Liberty sticking up in the sand. It's like, oh, awesome. So, I don't know what the deal is. Do I have to do a different race with him?
So, that sounds like an unlockable.
No, because there's three. Yeah.
Huh, okay.
Because also, I was like, where's the snow in the Alpine track? Because there's three segments to it. He was showing his mom video games. Her first video games was going to be the 360. And so she's just getting used to the controls and everything. He's going through like all the launch titles with her.
Oh, wow.
He was like, oh, Fight Night. That didn't go over so well. And then, and then puts in Condemned. Now, do you remember the game Condemned?
No, I've seen the cover. I've seen the cover box for it. I've never actually played it.
Some people affectionately call it Bum Fight 360. Basically, yes. It's like you're a police officer. You go to an abandoned building to investigate a murder, and then like you get cut off, and then you somehow the police think that you've actually committed the murder, and there's like a psychopath who's in the abandoned building, and you're trying to do this police procedural kind of CSI thing, but most of it is actually like first person melee combat with a lot of really deranged homeless people who live in the building. And the guy was
I think Yahtzee mentioned this in passing when he was describing some other game.
It's actually very well done for a launch title. But anyway, he was describing this thing. He goes, yeah, she was starting to get the hang of the controls, and then I just watched in horror as my mom stepped back to dodge the attack of the homeless person, zapped him with a taser, and then moved in for the kill with a piece of rebar. Because I slid my chair ever so slightly away from her at that moment. It was like very cold and calculating. She like, okay, hit him with the taser, stun him. Okay, now finish him off with the piece of rebar.
Yes. Yeah.
He was like, yeah, it's all here. You want to try? Now, what is... Am I doing a quick race, or what's the deal here? Audio all... Is there something different? Because, yeah, I'm pretty sure...
So...
Unless you...
Change the game type? Excuse me?
Game type what? I mean, skill level, but what is the game type?
Well, I mean, he blathers... The narrator guy, X-Man, blathers on early. Says there's two types. There's you race me, or you do a time trial thing.
Oh, damn it. Does this one at least let you quit? Did they learn that?
Well, you could pause it, and a menu did show up when you paused it.
Well, except I gotta sit through the loading screens. Innovation! Show something during the loading screen. There we go. Quick game, game options, instant replay. Wasn't I racing Iceman, though?
That's what it looked like.
Or is he gonna now blather?
Oh, what's wrong?
Does your widow waste car driver want to go home?
Okay.
So.
Phenomena.
So if our winner contacts you, is he going to... That'll be the second part of the contest. You have to listen two episodes in a row to claim your prize. And nobody else pretending to be him, spoofing his YouTube account or whatever.
No, I'm sure there's a
private message to you. No, yeah, I'm totally this guy. Yeah, so I just changed YouTube accounts and since
we'll figure
double check if he's logged in recently.
we'll figure something out. Yeah, anyway, give us a.
If you have any Starcade paraphernalia, or
oh my gosh,
or swag,
oh my gosh,
which it should. I asked you about
actually.
That.
So, if anyone who was crazy enough to watch that episode,
you wouldn't.
Wouldn't what?
Never. Okay, go ahead.
I'm not parting with it, but I still have the Christmas ornament, okay. And it still works.
Maybe you'll append that to the end of this video.
Maybe I will.
Let's have some proof that this this is some really good LEDs you have in there, man. You remember to take the battery out of it so it didn't leak after?
there was no battery in it. It was an external battery. It ran off a 9-volt.
Learned that lesson.
Yeah.
Remove your batteries from your toys, kids, or else when you go to sell them on eBay in 10 years, you're going to be acid leaking out of it.
Yeah, I was surprised to find some of those old Milton Bradley, Mattel, or handheld electronic games are selling for kind of scary amounts of money.
Yes, I know. I keep thinking of all the garage sales that my mom has had since. there is Brenan Baird, opponent. Which I'm pretty sure they called him X-Man. Okay. At some point, either in the video or someplace, somebody referred to him as X. Either
Michael St. John Smith, the policeman,
Chris Roberts, from
Lord British. What?
Yeah, are they basically thanking everybody who hadn't yet been acquired by EA at that point? We're about to be acquired.
Institute of British Special Columbia thing. Institute of Technology. I guess they came up with the physics model.
Hmm. Can you learn more? Well, actually, I haven't guessed if we. Hadn't been talking during the beginning of the credits. I'm sure they would have mentioned who the physics model was licensed from. Maybe. So they could have. Hey, wait. Did they innovate the... Oh, I was going to say maybe they innovated the scrolling backwards on the credits at this point. But nope, not quite.
Nope, not quite.
I wanted to see the Statue of Liberty. Well, you can look it up on YouTube. Look up Statue of Liberty 3DO Need for Speed, and I'm sure it'll be there.
I'm sure it's in a video somewhere. Videos of everything else.
Yeah, I got the biggest chuckle out of that when I saw that, but yeah, I can't remember what it was like if you had to race, or did I have to, basically I didn't set the right mode in here by talking to Mr. X-Man.
Okay, here's the deal. You can fly it solo, race against the clock, or we're gonna have some real fun, and you can take me on.
But I took you on.
What do you say?
Interesting. Maybe it's a time trial or whatever.
All right, so how do you select that?
Yes, thank you. Well, wait a minute.
So he's just there.
Oh. No, that's the car.
That's the car, the road, the controls. All right.
I mean, I'm doing the thing that I always hate, which is,
Lane, traction control, ABS, opponent video on...
Opponent video. Nice, you can turn that off. Oh, I keep. I'm so used to B is back or whatever, It's recent controller, shall we say?
Yeah, it's interesting, playing modern games and then going back to playing these where controls roll all over the place on Nintendo and 3DO and early PlayStation games. And now they all seem to have settled down. To a fairly repeatable, fairly consistent set of controls. A does a thing and B backs you out.
Oh, interesting.
Oh, what'd you do?
I hit play when I was on the... Yeah, see, this is... Nope, he's still there. What the hell?
There.
Is there an option maybe in the game itself?
Game options...
Yeah.
Hmm.
Nothing that isn't already there.
Wow. I don't know.
Oh.
Well, I don't know.
Oh, well.
Oh, well.
Well, that was a fun little trip down memory lane.
Yeah.
One of the better 3DO games. This also plays with the analog controller, apparently.
Really?
Pretty well.
Oh, okay.
Yes. I keep saying I should bring that over on some of these games. Maybe, I don't know, maybe Wing Commander or something.
Wing Commander, or does it work with
Wing Commander? Is not just for steering, but because it's got
Starfighter.
Because it's got the, yes, I believe so.
Yes.
It's got the extra buttons, which makes really good in Wing Commander, because you've got the...
all those the like hat squad commands.
Yeah.
And
yeah, like the little hat controller, the thumb stick that goes onto your... because it's, you know, an analog stick, but then there's a little thumb digital stick in that, and then of course you got the multiple buttons on both the triggers and the top, and also on the base. It's just like, yeah, it makes Wing Commander much more bearable. Wing Commander 3, not Super Wing Commander, that's a piece of crap. So they didn't do much in the way of porting that. I mean, we should do Super Wing Commander. I believe I have it.
Really?
It's just for the, you know, really, guys, you couldn't record him saying, you got 3, you got 5, you got 7. You had to piece it together from, you got 4, Maverick. It's just like, you have a CD, okay? Oh, lead artist, programming, CD artist, track modeling, SRL, digital art, Philip Chow. Some of these names are vaguely familiar.
Music.
Audio post-production. Back when you only needed one tester.
Yes.
Well, it says lead tester, so we'll assume that he has minions who live in their cars and aren't paid much.
I walked up to the door. I ran up to the door. I jumped up and down in front of the door. I threw grenades at the door.
Oh, yeah, there's include a link to that. Oh.
That was a great, great summary.
Yeah, that showed up on Gamma Sutra. Is that where you originally found it? Or
no, I found it. Somebody had linked to it on the Book of Faces.
But it showed up as a blog posting on Gamma Sutra like the next day after you gave that to me. That's Yes, that is. I'm going to. I think I should get that printed poster size and put it above my desk.
Yes, but, the door problem. Yes.
Yes, which it's funny. I've worked on games where doors were a big issue. That's why I was doubly fine, where it's like literally we were like in the middle of, well, I joined the team a little bit, Lord British Chris Roberts, well, you know, where I joined the team and it was like, okay, this is an alpha, we're showing it to the execs, and literally they get up to the first door, the door slides open, okay, and it's like, stop the demo, that door doesn't look really good. It's like it's an alpha.
Yeah.
It's like 1/1000th of the game, you know, where it's like much bigger things, but nope, we gotta stop down. You gotta fix that door. It's like, okay. Yeah. Well, no, but it's literally like it became a big deal, and it's like every game after that at this company, the first thing to go in was doors. Really, really exquisitely opening doors. Doors that was like, you know, would slide open with perfection and animate and was complete with sound and, you know, and could never glitch and be stuck or anything. So it's like, and in the code, it was just shocking that like doors have no reason of being their own thing, really. You know, they really, you know, a door, it animates open. Maybe sometimes it has to be locked because whatever. Maybe sometimes it has to be locked because, you know, there's nothing behind it and, you know, it's got to wait till it opens.
Yeah.
Very simple code. But I just remember seeing doors having their own file, their own logic, like often their own like sub AI state machine or whatever. It'd all be traced back to like this one just demo to an exec who just couldn't get past literally the door, you know. It was just like, that's a really crappy looking door. My God, this is terrible. You gotta stop, right? You gotta fix that right now, like
gotta
tomorrow.
Fix it right now.
Exactly. It's like, don't you want to see all the advanced character modeling and lovely environments that we have
with my name on it, unless that door is fixed?
Yeah, the lovely.
I talk fast and hot.
The lovely environments, the sound design, you know, the correction values, the wonderful, you know, story and puzzles and all the stuff. Next gen. No. We gotta fix the doors. and apparently that's like every exec has some fetish like this. Apparently, what was it? I saw this about like the guys who did Too Human. Who are no longer Silicon Knights or whatever. They were doing an X-Men.
Too Human. Oh my gosh.
They were doing an X-Men.
One of Yahtzee's epic SmackDown interviews. Well, Two Humans, my favorite kind of game to review because it's bad. None of that wishy-washy mediocrity where they have to admit that the soundtrack was nice or that the gameplay was slightly more entertaining than lacerating my gums on the edge of a rusty tin. This is just all bad all the time.
Two Human is my favorite kind of game to review because it's bad. None of that wishy-washy mediocrity where I have to admit that the soundtrack was nice or that the gameplay was slightly more entertaining than lacerating my gums on the edge of a rusty tin. This is just all bad all the time.
No. Actually, I played it. It's not that bad.
Okay.
I actually kind of enjoyed what I was playing. Mm-hmm. Now, if I'd been waiting 2 years for it with bated breath, yeah, I'd be kind of pissed.
Okay.
But no, I thought it was perfect. I thought it had an original idea. It had some nice ideas in there. Mm-hmm. I thought, oh, this could be an interesting series to see what it develops into.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just like there was so much drama in the production of the game with the lawsuits going back and forth between Silicon Knights and Epic and all that stuff. But they were talking about during the production, like one of the things that was distracting them was with Silicon Knights, and they had some deal with Activision or something about making an X-Men game.
Mm-hmm.
And somebody was talking about, like, one of the producers just had a thing about that truck's got to be red. Like you know, everything else is totally broken in the game. It's like, that truck's got to be red.
Duly noted.
Exactly. Like it's in, like in making like in the final game, you notice like almost every truck is red. You know, it's like okay, red. Okay, we just stop. It's like not worried about like the game is horribly late, the horribly broken. Nothing. You know, it's going to be a terrible game.
But the truck's red.
But the truck is red. Yes, the truck has been made red. It's like,
Actually, when I was read the door problem thing, I was remembering the considerations that I had to give to doors in Monster Manor.
Yes,
which is
they open.
Can
you close them again?
Do the doors swing open or do they slide open?
Yes.
The answer was they swing open.
Yes.
Then the next question was if they swing open, do they shove the player out of the way?
Yes.
And so I punted on that.
Most games do.
Yeah, so basically it's a solid block. It's a solid block. If the door is closed, it's a solid block, and you bump up against it as if it's a solid block. The door is open, then you can go through it. It's basically a transport. So it's those two states. Yeah. So you're never really shoved out of the way. You're never close enough that the door would shove you out of the way, so to speak.
Most games solve that problem the other way, which is the doors open either way. So whichever side of the door is on, they open away from you so that there's no worry about collision detection or phasing through the door in any way, shape, or form. Because it's like, wow, that's some really weird architecture.
Mm-hmm.
Or they just make doors that slide. You know, that's the other way to do it. That's the other way to get around it. You notice that like Doom did that.
Right.
I think Quake even still did that. For Quake and Doom,
actually,
I think it's
Hexen, the door swung open and shoved you out of the way.
Oh, interesting. I remember that being like an early thing with the Quake/Doom engine was if the door slid.
I think it's Hexen 2, actually, but yeah.
If the door slid, it actually meant that there was no issue with the BSP trees.
Right.
Because everything had to be brushes.
Right, because they only went up and down.
Right.
They didn't go sideways.
It wouldn't cause problems with the BSP trees. And then I guess finally realized, well, not everything in the world has to be a goddamn brush. I think they probably figured that out for Hexen.
Mm-hmm.
So it was like, you know, the doors are probably just like little physics objects on top of the world, like they did in Dark Forces or something like that. But yeah. Wow, we're really drowning out here. Look at that lovely glass logo. We've got a ray tracer. Early 3D. Yeah, you can do that in real time.
Yeah.
Real time.
I don't know.
Yes, like, yes. Really? Real time ray tracing. Real time ray tracing. They showed it at GDC on mobile GPUs.
Oh, God.
They actually have a ray trace engine, and I think it's PowerVR, whatever,
was
showing off a rate. Basically, one section of their GPU is devoted entirely to ray tracing.
Really?
And on a mobile, in a mobile GPU. Yes, in a mobile GPU. And I was thinking, God, what's that for? And I was like, oh, wait a minute. Augmented reality is probably like something you'd want. Because, like, why would you want that on a mobile GPU? Why do you have to be that specialized? And it's like, somebody's thinking of augmented reality.
It's going to add it to Foculous, Facebooky, whatever they're calling it.
Oh, are you still mad about, you know?
Man.
Well, are you just mad because they didn't give you $2 billion or whatever
they
paid for?
What made me mad was when Facebook bought whatever the hell it was, that messaging service for $19 billion. And I went, wow, if I write an XMPP client, can I have $19 billion too?
Well, I assume they had some infrastructure beside them or whatever. It wasn't just an app, was it? I mean, didn't they actually have server type stuff?
They had server type stuff. Apparently the big trick was your phone number was your ID. So it was basically a substitute for the text messaging service
right.
that yeah. your phone provider had, but in Europe was hideously expensive.
Right.
So they
you just have to well, remember, you just have to be the last guy who comes up with something. Remember that? So that's what they taught us at school. It was like, it's not the first guy who gets the credit, it's the last guy who gets the credit. Like, it's like, oh, do you know who invented this? Wrong! It was really somebody much earlier invented calculus. But because this guy actually wrote it down and documented it so well that nobody ever questioned that he invented it ever again. So that's why, you know, the last guy is the guy who gets the credit. That's not the first guy. So I was like, yes. People, I'm sure, did similar things. There are several apps that did that, but the guy who did so well that everybody used it and called it Kleenex or whatever instead of facial tissue, they're the ones that get the money.
I am never forget the day, the first time I meet the great Lobachevsky. In one word, he tell me secret of becoming a great mathematician. Plagiarize.
Oh, yeah. Yes, yes, yes. Facebook. I actually ordered an Oculus Rift. The new ones.
Mm-hmm.
The DK2 variety. Okay. And actually might have gotten
the big
in...
blue F.
What?
With a big blue F on the side?
What? No. It's the dev kit okay. version 2. But technically, it was made before...
Mm-hmm.
Before the announcement.
Right.
I ordered it after the announcement, though, because I think I got a chance to actually get in because a lot of people canceled their orders because of the whole Facebook thing.
Okay.
Well, you saw Minecraft, the guys.
Marcus Pearson said, nope, I'm done.
Yeah. And I'm sure he'll change. Well, then again, he probably doesn't give a crap because he's got so much money now. But, yeah, he might have a change of heart later when it's like, oh, yeah, I never say never. But then it's like... I'm sure the guys at Bungie originally said, sell to Microsoft. Sure. Nah, not like that'll happen. We're Mac guys all the way, dude. Just, how many zeros in that check? Okay.
VRville.
What? Yeah. You laugh. Wouldn't you want to just have an Oculus Rift just to play around with?
I've never actually seen one in person. I'm actually kind of hoping for the Cast AR. Will do relatively well,
yeah.
Which is created by a friend of mine named Jerry Ellsworth. Done a lot of excellent work on that thing.
See, at least with the Oculus, got it.
And the Cast AR I've seen in person. It's actually kind of cool.
Yeah.
Have you seen the Cast AR?
I have not seen the Cast AR, okay. But I assume it's something like what the 3DS does, which is...
No.
If you've ever played with a 3DS. No. In terms
I think the 3DS is a lenticular grid.
No, I'm talking about the 3DS has a camera on it.
Yeah.
And then one of the things is like if you point at the desktop, it'll like little things, like things will start coming out of the, like, you know, it's like a little trapdoor open up in the desktop and like little stuff will come out. And it's like, oh, look, it's a little game. There's little creatures playing on your desk. Isn't that cute? Or, oh, look, here's I'm playing Face Tris or whatever, where it's like people's faces suddenly, you know, get detached and do stuff, you know.
I have not seen that.
Well, it's one of the few cool things.
I don't get out much anymore, do I? Apparently.
That's one of the few cool things the 3DS can do. Oh,
okay.
Is, you know, it does the augmented reality thing, mm-hmm. where it's like, it has a camera and you can, like, you know, play games where it's mm-hmm. like stuff has been kind of put into the environment, kind of.
Hmm.
I'm sure there are other good games for the 3DS, but yeah. I have not partaken in it. But leave it up to Nintendo. And people have done that. But yes, I'm sure the Cast AR is cool. And who knows? Maybe Facebook has so much money they could probably just, you know, buy every last one of the augmented reality / virtual reality setups.
Okay,
although I thought it was kind of funny that they let slip last week. They said that Mark Zuckerberg asked for a personal demonstration of Sony's Morpheus. Like the week before he bought Oculus.
Oh.
It's like, what does that say about...
okay.
What he thought of the two. It's like, it's not like Facebook... Well, actually, I don't know. If Facebook's actually made Sony an offer for their gaming division, he probably would have said yes, because they've been doing everything to raise capital. I mean, yeah, the PS4 is selling okay,
mm-hmm.
but it's not clear how much money they're making off it, and also they've been selling off a lot of stuff to try and get their... Because they've been losing money, I guess, on TVs and phones and stuff. So
yeah, they're Sony's doing a huge amount of reorganization. And,
yeah. I thought that was funny. So yeah, Zuckerberg asked for a personal demonstration. Of course, you don't say no to Mark Zuckerberg. And then okay, I'm gonna go buy Oculus. Because either he thought Oculus was that much better, oh, or he thought that, you know, he basically, I guess you could say it's like he either thought either Oculus was worth more money, or he thought Sony's wasn't going to be much of a competition if he did buy it or something. So, or if they figured, like, well, if Sony's doing virtual reality, then there must be something to this this newfangled virtual reality thing that we've been talking about since the 1993 or whatever.
1990, sorry, the 1950s with 3D, you know, red, blue, 3D.
Well, that's not, well, that's a little different. I mean, well, this is it. Yeah, it's a little different than 3D, than just 3D. Yeah, if you got a new set, dude, you could do 3D. Well, you sort of supposed to be able to do 3D, but...
It's, well, you can... You can just plug in. You have to plug in the right hardware, but you can do. Well, I mean, you can do 3D. You can do 3D with an NVIDIA card on my TV set. Tested it. It works. The trouble is, like, getting all that set.
My Blu-ray player does 3D on your set as well.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Oddly enough, the one company that doesn't make that never made a 3D set, or at least a DLP set, is the only company who makes a Blu-ray player that actually supports DLP sets natively with 3D. It's like, what? It's like Samsung? No. Yeah. Mitsubishi? No. It's Panasonic? Yes. It's like, what? Why? I don't get it. Whatever. All right. Well, let's wrap this up.
Okay.
After let's some wrap heavy this up. Editing.
Yeah. So. Kind of like seriously off the rails here, but that's okay.
I'm hungry and I've got to have dinner.
So. Well, all right. We'll let you go and have dinner. And thank you all for joining us. And we'll see you next time.
So nice to know you. How are you?
I'm fine.
Good. You got any hobbies or anything you want to tell us about?
Yeah, I'm into computers and electronics.
Good for you. What's that in your hand?
This is a little goofy Christmas ornament I put up as a college project. It just flashes lights randomly. I don't think you can see it in the lights.
Good. Well, in that case, disconnect the battery and we'll move on. All right, nice day.
Still got it. And it still works.